next to the state library, and my house was next to the primary school. My mom was the headmistress of the primary school, you know. So I used to go to the library and make some research on art and drawing, and that was how I got hooked, you know, on art. My father was a high court judge, no matter then, so that explains why I decided to study law. In my house, you could study only two professions, law or medicine. Well, you can say the third one is family disgrace. If you don't study any of those two, whatever you study is family disgrace. So as a result, I saw that law was, you know, my thing. I didn't think. But by the time I got into university, so people will say I'm a dropout. And I'm so glad I made that decision, because
in university, life was awesome. You know, by final year, I'd become very popular. I had a business name called The Zulu. That's what they know me for. I used to make posters and portraits. And oh, during Valentine, all the boys are coming to commission portraits of their girlfriends. That's when I realized I'll never be poor, you know? So when I got into Lagos, I also then realized that Lagos was a crazy city. You know, people would pay for anything. I said, wow, you know, amazing. I'm going to settle here. Immediately after law school, my father died, you know. So I was a youth couple with no dad, no money. But I was lucky. I had an aunt in Suleri called Mrs. Obiezami, and she was in the habit of harboring, you know, confused young men, you know, and giving them free food and accommodation. And I was lucky to stay in her house on Randall Avenue in Surulere. And she was quite a sophisticated woman, so she understood the idea. Fam. Anyway, so I started painting, you know. And then I could only afford pencil and cardboard paper, so I started making drawings. And sold the drawings and bought watercolor paper, started painting watercolor. I started attending all these art exhibitions in Lagos, you know. I got into the world of the arts, you know, people like Overaiti, Kainebi, Kolado Oshinowo, you know, Yusuf Grillo. It was amazing, you know, like huge art exhibitions going on in Lagos, and I enjoyed, I reveled in it. So I wanted to belong to that world, and I started making my paintings right on the balcony of Auntie Nena's house, and I decided I was going to have an exhibition.
photographers, Richard James Ira, crazy guy. We used to have, you know, spend time in his dark room. I started using his dark room in Sweden. I was walking distance from Auntie Lena's house. And one thing led to the other. And I found myself being part of a group of Nigerian photographers representing Nigeria in Mali, Bamako, Mali. They had this biennale. Every 2 years, they would have a huge photography exhibition of African photography, curators from all over the world, you know? And somebody told the curator about my work, and he came and he looked at it and I said, yeah, well, I want your work as part of that exhibition. The process of creating an artwork in itself demands a deep knowledge of oneself and what one wants to say, and slightly ignoring the world and digging deep into your experiences and bringing out something authentic. But once the artwork is produced, then it exists. You've brought it into existence. It becomes for me a commodity, because you need to exchange it for money. Then the businessman kicks in, you know? Then I say, okay, good, you know? Who are the clients who would like to buy this? And how do you present it to them, you know? And presentation in artwork is so important. You know, I always give examples. Say if you take an original Picasso, I go under the bridge at the Guernabah, you're carrying a bell and you're ringing and say, ah, buy your Picasso, yes, buy your Picasso. You'll probably get exactly the same amount of pay for a loaf of bread and get your bread under the bridge, you know? But take the same artwork and go to Sotheby's or Christie's, and the first bidding will probably be $20 million, you know? So it's a matter of how do you present the artwork, who are you presenting it to? So for me, even now as a commercial photographer, I find time to do my own personal work. And even when I'm doing commercial work, I like to infuse some of my own ideas into it as much as the client would permit. So it still has, you know, a mark of Kelechi Amadi-Obi on it.